Hello, and welcome to UIPATH RPA Project. And this is the introduction video about the UIPATH RPA Project, where we will go to different websites and we will download the data. So here I will be explaining you detail about this project and then what all is required to complete this project. First of all, that we will have some data. From that data, we have to loop through each record and we have to perform certain tasks. As you can see right now on your screen, I have mentioned all the steps which we are going to take in this project. First of all, I will give you an introduction about the variables and how is the entire project structured in the upcoming part of this video. And now about the workflows. So the first workflow is main workflow, where we will loop on the each record of the Excel. So let me show you the Excel file. And you can have this data in a database, or you can have this data into a cloud platform or SFTP anywhere. But this is how the data will come. All right, and it might have more record as per your project requirement. And these are the randomly search records on the different county websites. And only used for the illustration purpose. All right, so what we will do, that we will go to all of these records one by one, and we will perform all actions for each record. Okay, now the question is, what are those all actions? You can come back and you can read here. So how will we navigate to three different counties? We will see the name here, and from here we will take this URL for that particular county, and then we will perform rest of the actions on the county website. And these are those county websites which we have in the scope. All right, so I'll just close this tab. So after going on the website, we have to search for few documents. I will take you to the presentation back. So we have to search for the document. We will create folders with the customer name and timestamp. And we will have three different workflows for each county. And how we will call the workflow, we will understand by the name. So here you can see the name, Orange and Miami and DuPage. And I will take you to the project folder now. Here is the project folder. So I have already created these three counties workflows, which we will be calling inside this read data XML file. So these all will be called inside this. And all the actions which we have to perform are available inside these workflows. So I can show you one workflow, for example, in this video. So there are already videos which are done and the link for the playlist of this project is available in the description. So you can subscribe to the channel, and you can also get the link of this RPA project playlist in the description of this video. Okay, so this is the workflow for this county. So you can see right now on your screen. So I have already recorded entire development process for all three counties, and videos are available in the playlist. You can watch each video and you can practice it. And the first video will be little longer because I have explained everything in detail. Okay, let's go back to the presentation. So once we have developed all the county workflows here till this point, the next is that we have to loop on each record and we have to break the address into house number, street and other parts which are required. So which are those required part, I will explain in the coming part of this video. And this is how we will connect entire workflow. So the main workflow which is running on the Excel will call county workflows inside it, and it will perform all the actions which are required in the process. So you should know few things which are here. You should know how to install UIPath Studio. So link is available in the description, or you can search in Google UIPath Studio community version. And then you should have some basic programming skills. And then you should understand the UIPath selector and UIPath explorer, which you can just browse from here. This is UIPath Studio and this is UIPath explorer. You can learn more about this on UIPath document also. And I am using classic view. So when you will create the project in UIPath from here you can create new project. And if you want to add workflow file in the same project, then you can go here and you can add workflow files. So I have created only one project and I have added different workflow files. From in the project, if you don't see the layout like this, go in the project, go in the setting, you will have this modern design. Just turn it off. Okay. These are the few things which you should know about before you start this project. Now let's go back to the presentation. And you should also understand about folder exist, element exist, create folder in UiPath. So these all are the activities in UiPath. So when you will go in the activity panel, you can see activity panel here also. Sometimes it will be here in this side, or you can browse through all the activities which I have mentioned. Alright, now let's go to the next slide. So this is the schedule of each video you can see on your screen right now. And all of these videos will be available on the mentioned dates. And the link of the playlist will be available in the description of each video so that you can click on that link and reach on the playlist directly. But if you are starting from this video, you don't have to worry about other parts, because you can start from anywhere, and in the end, the video number 6 is where I will connect all the workflows. So you can start from video number 1, you can start from video number 4, you can start from video number 5. You don't have to worry about the starting point, but watch the complete video together at one time, okay, so that you understand the entire flow. Otherwise, you have to do some revisions once again. So there is one more thing, like the structure of the website can change anytime, but the basic concept will remain same. So you don't have to worry if you see some other image or if you see some other structure of the website tomorrow, because these are the county website. They have all the rights to change them anytime. But the basic concept will remain same. How to click, how to check the folder, that will remain always same. Only thing is that your click and typing steps will be changed. So there are few notes which I have mentioned here. You can pause the video and have a look on this. And for the better understanding, I will recommend that if you can use two devices, you can play the video into one device and you can learn the project into another device. Okay, now let's go to the next point. So here I have mentioned once again in detail that what all we are going to do. So I will request you to have a look. So I have explained all of these details in the previous slide as well. These are the same detail, but still you can read and understand once again. Pause the video and have a look. So now here I am explaining the entire transaction flow. So first of all, what we will do, that we will read the data from Excel. So these two first and second boxes are covered in the single workflow, which is read Excel. So you will have four different data which is available in Excel. So you will have the address, you will have the URL, you will have the county name, and you will have the owner name as well. So four variables you will be transferring from here to the next sequence. So this is a sequence where we will break the entire address into three different parts, and the total number of the variables becomes 7. If we will send these all the data, and then we will check that what is the county name, and then we will call only that particular county workflow, and rest of the action will be performed, and there will be one output status which will be returned by the county workflow. Hope you understood this. So any part which you cannot understand in entire project, you can mention the time and you can mention your question. These are the required variables. So we require these variables before we call the county workflow. So we will have these as a variable in main workflow, which is read Excel. And then in other workflows, it will be used as argument, which will take the data or send the data. So these are a few points which I have mentioned about the length of the videos. So all the videos in this project will be more than 1 hour and less than 1 hour 15 minutes. So video timing is very long, because I explain everything in detail, and then I cover up few things in the first video, I cover up few things in the second video, I cover up few things in the third video, and there might be few corrections also which will come in the end, or which will come into different videos. So please watch complete video whenever you start and complete this project. Share the feedback in the comments. And if you want to understand anything, or if you want to suggest me more projects, you can give me your suggestions. Subscribe to the channel, like my videos, share my channel link to others, that will really help me. Thanks a lot. Let's start and complete this project in this month. So I am taking you once again back on the schedule. So this is the schedule for your reference once again. So this is the schedule once again for your reference. See you in the next video.